First time we've seen these cars starting not on a staggered grid, remember. They're doing line starts now, so you're going to see four cars across the line in one of these races. Larson on the inside line gets a great start, takes that jump. Kevin Eriksson squeezing through, though. Eriksson found amazing traction, pinches the car in, goes high on the banking.
What is that?
Gets the exit and gets the lead. So Kevin Eriksson backed it in there, Jared. He just kept it lit off the start. That was incredible.
That gravel machine gun was all up in your face. Are you kidding me? Took the widest line we've seen. Talking about Benito, did you see how crazy he went up there?
That's it. That's insane.
That was
so
wild.
We've seen Travis take the high line. Kevin, I thought, had got better traction off the start, but I think he's stayed in the throttle longer, Jared, because he knows he's going to take the high line. And in fact, Larson's right there. Robin Larson looks up the inside. He might give Kevin a little nudge, hooks the wheel over the berm, and decides not to this time round.
Look how shiny it is up on that top deck. Did you see how shiny it was? I mean, that is ice. The drivers have been saying it. And look at Robin Larson taking that tighter line, because there is the dust. You know, you're seeing the loose dirt, airing it out over that finish line.
Yeah, maybe finding a bit more traction there, Jared. This is what Travis was saying earlier. He wants to see people try those different lines. If we get blue groove, you might find a little bit like when you get a wet track sometimes, the other line will work better. Larson goes straight to the standard lap, and is it standard or joker? I can't remember with these guys. First time we've seen them using it.
What's that?
Standard lap. Kevin Eriksson's gone joker, so Kevin's gone to the shortcut, which is pretty much what we thought. So leader will always joker on lap one, in my opinion, because we don't want to give up.
Whoa.
Oh, nose high. That got the air under it, didn't it? That got the air under it. So Kevin Eriksson, look at the gap he's got. Oh, it was 10.9 is the gap. So we thought the delta was about 10 seconds. But for me, particularly in dusty conditions, you're always going to joker from the lead because you want to make it difficult for everyone behind you.
Kevin Eriksson is looking really tidy right now. It seems that he has found the special sauce. He is working with the slickness. But again, what you ask of that equipment, it might bite back. So imagine going from that slick and that blue groove and then hitting that curtain. That could very well debead your tire.
Yeah, absolutely. He's up the gap, Jared. It's gone up to 11.7, timing screen showing. So Eriksson's trying to get away. 11.1, so Larson takes 6/10 off. And there you go, gap left-hand side of your screen. The little red diamond there shows you whether or not they've jokered. Remember, this is a shortcut joker here at Mid-America Outdoors for the Group E cars. It's the other way around for side-by-side and also for NRX Next.
Yeah, look at that. You see a little squirrely on the landing there. So Kevin Eriksson still out front. Remember, this is a three-lap race for all of these battle heats.
I think Larson will stay out, Jared. So I don't think he'll go
to the last one.
Yeah, so he's got the gap down to 11.0. So it's not a lot. It was 6/10, then it was a 10th. But if Larson can continue to take those off, then he might, when he gets the shortcut, joker, be able to get alongside Kevin Eriksson. So Eriksson's joker first because he wants to keep that dust out of his vision. You're not going to joker and put yourself back in traffic. He's got perfect vision in front of him. But he's behind him. Larson going to close him down. He's taken another 10th off him. It goes down to 10.9. Larson's on it.
Yep, Larson is gaining some ground, but is it enough? As you said, taking that joker lap on that final lap. Here comes Kevin Eriksson. Look at that, working all the course, getting to the loose stuff.
You can hear the cars howling, can't you? Here, we've got such great onboard audio, like the noise from them. Tires squealing, the Yokohama's scrambling away on that blue groove. Here comes Larson now, 10.9 was what it was last time we checked the sectors. Guerra has gone to his joker, Benito Guerra from.
That 10.9, can Larson close the gap?
10.8, and another 10th. He keeps nicking a 10th there and a 10th there. So this could be close. Travis Pastrana sent all the drivers an update earlier this week saying the delta is about 10 seconds, we think. So if that's the case, Larson could be very close indeed when he takes his shortcut lap on this run round.
Larson getting super steady down the hill. He crosses that finish line. 10.6, he gains another 2/10. 10.6, can Larson gain the ground on Eriksson? Remember, the winner of this goes to the Battle Finals, which is going down tomorrow.
Watch Larson, gonna go left now. Kevin Eriksson coming up over the big step up jump. Robin Larson gonna come around the outside line. The gap was 10.6. Kevin Eriksson nearly goes end over end. Larson comes in behind. 10.6 is definitely enough, Jared. A record, maybe even.
It
was easily enough, but Larson did a wheelie jump, didn't he?
Yeah,
and Kevin put it on the nose.
Kevin did a nosedive. He did an endo as opposed to a wheelie. These guys are doing more Nitro Circus stuff than Nitro Cross stuff.
They are. Let's get
a double backflip. What are you doing, Benito?
That's easy.
Yeah.
Oh, my man. Yeah.
Kevin Eriksson gets it done. Robin Larson was, you know what? That just goes to show you. you know, it's getting faster. Find the sweet spot. Maybe Kevin was making some mistakes, so the perfect storm.
Looks like about 9.5, doesn't it? Remember that delta changes with track conditions. Travis had said about 10. We saw the gap, I think, was down to 10.6, yep, wasn't it, when he eventually went. And he was 1 second behind on the next split. So we're saying 9.5 at the minute is the delta for the Joker. But Kevin Eriksson coming around the long left-hander. Battle one, he's going to take the checkered flags. He boosts it up over the tabletop. Great job by him. He goes through to the battle final tomorrow. Larson gets P2, and Benito Guerra going to come around for third. Yeah, it was good, wasn't it?